Der er fart på, når 43-årige Peter Wright triller gennem gaderne i London. Han mistede begge sine ben efter en trafikulykke i 1992 og har siden da været bundet til en kørestol. Men gennem årene er det blevet lettere for ham at komme rundt i byen.
It's getting a lot better. I've been travelling into central London now for 10 years. And when I first started, I could only use one or two routes. Now I can use all the buses, and I've got a growing number of underground stations I can use. So it's a lot better.
Der bor cirka 1,4 millioner mennesker med handicap eller gangbesvær i London, og det offentligt ejede selskab Transport for London har derfor haft en vigtig udfordring med at sikre, at alle mennesker, uanset handicap, kan komme rundt i byen med busser og i undergrundsbanen.
All of the buses in London are step-free. They all have audiovisual information on them. 20% of the underground network is step-free. I think certainly within London, there is an expectation that we need to do things to make the transport network more accessible for disabled people. And people accept that it's the fringe benefit for them that they now have lifts if they've got heavy luggage or a child in a pushchair.
Transport for London har gennem årene gjort meget for at skabe bedre forhold for gangbesværede rejsende. Der er bygget flere lifte og elevatorer for at få step-free eller trinfri adgang fra gadeplan og ned til togene. Her på Westminster Tube Station har man som noget nyt sat en glasvæg op mellem undergrundstogene og passagererne, så det fremover bliver overflødigt at sige mind the gap please, fordi mellemrum og niveauforskelle er væk. Kørestolsbrugere og andre kan dermed trille direkte ind i togene fra perronen. Der er tale om meget store investeringer. 65 millioner pund, svarende til godt 500 millioner danske kroner, alene på en enkelt tubestation. Men pengene er fundet, fordi de forbedrede adgangsforhold er til gavn for alle mennesker, både med og uden handicap.
If you're just thinking about making things better for wheelchair users, it's a tiny percentage of the city's population. But actually the benefits of putting lifts in, the benefits of getting rid of stairs, actually have huge benefits for making journeys easier for the vast majority of the population. And if you're trying to quantify how much is the return on investment for some of these rather expensive projects, if you just focused on the very small number of wheelchair users, the cost-benefit analysis would never add up from a financial perspective. There may be all sorts of ethical reasons why you want to do it, but if you actually look at the improvements as they are made for a much wider group of people, then it becomes much more obvious why you'd spend the money.
London er verdenskendt for sine meget høje standarder, når det handler om tilgængelighed for alle. Faktisk er briternes standarder på flere områder højere end EU kræver. Bygninger med trin ved indgangen omtales som gamle, mens der i nye bygninger er direkte adgang for kørestolsbrugere. Også mange bænke er udstyret med armlæn, så ældre mennesker eller andre med gangbesvær lettere kan sætte sig og komme op igen. Alt sammen ud fra en tankegang om, at der i samfundet skal være plads til os alle, det man i England kalder the social inclusion model.
The social model is important for a number of reasons, and it's really about the dignity we should afford disabled people, in that they should be treated the same as everybody else, they shouldn't be discriminated against, and the fact that they have a disability or an impairment shouldn't preclude them from enjoying the services, for instance, or that everybody else can enjoy. And they may have to access that service in maybe a slightly different way or in an alternative way, but crucially they should be able to enjoy the service being offered the same as everybody else.
Også hos Transport for London er man meget opmærksom på værdien i den sociale model, og man har derfor lavet en særlig rådgivergruppe af mennesker med handicap, som giver råd og vejledning inden nye projekter sættes i gang.
I think when you work together in what almost amounts to a co-productive relationship, it helps both sides. That on the one hand, the organisation, so Transport for London, is less prone to making mistakes. They perhaps can do things more efficiently because we can help them to work out the best possible way of doing something. We get the kinds of solutions that will benefit more disabled people, and we get those in a way that actually does support the organisation in the delivery.
Det er som nævnt meget dyrt at ændre på gamle bygninger og transportsystemer for at gøre dem tidsvarende. Og anbefalingen fra det offentlige City of London er derfor også, at man stiller krav allerede før nye projekter godkendes.
When we look at planning applications, it's very cheap, incredibly cheap to change a drawing. It can go back to the design studios and be redrawn fairly cheaply. But when the building is actually constructed, those changes have a massive impact.
Men nogle gange er der ingen vej udenom dyre og kreative løsninger, som her ved den cirka 1000 år gamle St. Mary Le Bow Kirke, hvor man af æstetiske hensyn valgte at gøre den eksisterende trappe sammenklappelig. Se bare her. Pengene til trappen her er kommet fra en fond, og fra regeringens side opfordrer man i stigende grad befolkningen og andre til at tage et større økonomisk medansvar. En model, regeringen kalder for The Big Society. Her er ideen, at borgerne, frivillige foreninger, virksomheder og større organisationer sammen tager et medansvar og spiller en større rolle i samfundets generelle udvikling.
Big Society is about community development. It's about looking at your country as your home. And it's about understanding we are all in this together and we all need to develop that together and share and exchange knowledge. So at its heart, it's about the values and processes of community development, where you don't have to question a political color, you don't have to question an idea. You understand that we are all here trying to make sure that our house is healthy and happy, that when we grow up and live and move on and become old, that we all have something to say to each other and to contribute. And I think it's about that. It's about contributing towards the development of your community.
Meget er gjort i London, og meget mangler stadig. Men for Peter Wright er der ingen tvivl om, at indsatsen for større tilgængelighed allerede har gjort noget helt fundamentalt godt for ham.
People are used to seeing disabled people on public transport now. So we're not seen as anything different. And that's, to me, that's more of an improvement than all the physical access that they've put in, purely and simply because you're not when I first started, I used to get stared at when I was travelling on the underground. Now I don't. I joined the human race again. It's quite simple. It's as easy as that.